Now, the next part of our little story involves billing customers for expenses. Expenses that have been marked as billable will show in the Unbilled Cost By Job report. Of course, it will show there until it is placed on an invoice. Let's take a look at this report. From the main menu, click Reports, Jobs, Time, and Mileage, Unbilled Cost By Job. After we click it, we see that Kirschbaum for the Southwoods Road job has a check for supplies expense that we have not yet billed him for, and he has a bill for repair expense. Both of these directly relate to the job on Southwoods Road. He agreed to pay both of these and reimburse us for these two particular expenses. Because this report is so very important when managing your relationship with customers, we should click View and then add Unbilled Cost By Job to the icon bar. Then click OK, and now it will conveniently open from the icon bar. And now let's look at our first example. Let's imagine on February 25th, we billed Kirschbaum for an additional 5% of the Southwoods Road job. We'll include $400 of supplies that we paid for on February 15th. Let's take a look at how to bill the client for this expense. From the icon bar, we click Invoice. Now, we want to put the date of the invoice, which we said was February 25th. So we have to go forward to February 25th of 2017. Now look what happens at the moment we choose the Southwoods Road job. The first thing it asks us is this the estimate that we're making the invoice for? We click on it because it can be the only one, and we click OK, and then it asks us if we're going to make the estimate for the make the invoice for the remaining estimate or a percentage of the estimate. And of course, we know from the instructions that it's supposed to be just 5% of the job. So we click OK, and 5% of the job comes on to the invoice, just like it did in prior videos. But notice this box popped up, billable time cost. The customer or job you've selected has outstanding billable time and or cost. Do you want to select the outstanding billable time and cost to add to this invoice? In this case, yes. So if we click OK, then the window that opens up is the Choose Billable Time and Cost window. Notice you can put not only expenses on an invoice for a client for a job, but you could select specific items if you've marked them as billable. And in future videos, we will learn how to record vehicle mileage and time that we can record and mark as billable. And if so, they would appear in this window, Choose Billable Time and Cost. In our example, you can see the only unbilled time or cost that we have for Kirschbaum are expenses. We have two of them. We click here and we notice we're both here. Now, we were told in the instructions that on this particular invoice, we're only adding to this invoice the supplies from Staples that were purchased on February 15th. This will remain, this repair on February 20 will remain unbilled until a future invoice. So only this one, only this expense is going to be added to this invoice. We click OK, and if you scroll down, you will see that as we scroll down, you can see the two change orders that were on the estimate associated with this invoice. And when we get to the bottom, we can see that QuickBooks added to this invoice the $400 of supplies. We can click Save and New or Save and Close. But the most interesting thing is when you open the Unbilled Cost By Job, you see that the $400 check for supplies is no longer on the Unbilled Cost By Job. That's because it has been added to the invoice. And of course, the most important report is right here, the profit and loss by job. When we look at the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum, we can see that supplies expense has changed from 400 to zero. And the reason it became zero is because originally on February 15th, we bought supplies and associated it with the Kirschbaum job. But then on February 22nd, we have put those supplies on an invoice and asked Kirschbaum to pay for them. If Kirschbaum is paying for them, then we do not have supplies expense for the Kirschbaum job. And that's how it works. And now let's bill Kirschbaum for the repair. On February 27, we billed Kirschbaum for an additional 10% of the Southwoods Road job, and we will include on the February 27th invoice the $350 repair job that we received the bill for from Rex on February 20. Again, we open the invoice window, we move the date forward to February 27 of 2017, choose the Kirschbaum job, specifically Southwoods Road. We know that this is the estimate. Click OK. We know that we're putting in 10% of the estimate because that's what we completed since the last invoice. We click OK. Now it's asking us if we want to use the billable time or cost. We click OK, and we can see we have one expense remaining, this $350. We click here to select it and then click OK. And we know that it's all the way down at the bottom past the change orders, but this $350 repair has been added to the invoice because we're asking Kirschbaum to pay for it. Now all we have to do is click Save and Close. And again, we're not applying credits at this moment. When we look at the unbilled cost by job, there's nothing left because we just billed our last billable expense. And when we look at the profit and loss by job, we can see that the Southwoods Road job has no expenses because this repair expense that was $350 just a couple of minutes ago is now zero. It became zero at the minute we passed it on to our client Kirschbaum. We passed it on to him by way of putting it on an invoice and asking him to pay for it.